Hello from UC Davis Health, and thanks for joining us for this discussion on robotic surgery. I'm Pamela Wu, Director of News and Media Relations for UC Davis Health, and today we are joined by Dr. Bahareh Nejad, our Medical Director of Robotic Surgery. So you may be familiar with the idea of robots for industrial uses or even household uses like your Roomba vacuum. You may not necessarily think of robots as being a part of your surgical team in the operating room, but there they are, and they are helping to improve patient outcomes. So Dr. Nejad, thanks for being with us to talk about this.
Thanks for having me.
So people who aren't familiar with robotic surgery might think it means that a literal robot is serving as your surgeon. What does robotic, or I should say robotic-assisted surgery actually mean?
Yeah, so robotics is just a tool that we use. And luckily at UC Davis, we're fortunate to have so many different robotic systems for many different specialties. But essentially, your surgeon is still performing the operation. But it's one of the tools that we use to allow the surgery to be more minimally invasive with smaller incisions and some more precise or accurate work.
What causes you to look at a patient case and go, oh, this would be a great candidate for robotic surgery versus a traditional surgery?
Honestly, most of the robotic cases that we get, and I'm a gynecologist, but we serve many different specialties, are usually the most complex ones. And so we're really a referral center at UC Davis for Northern California. Patients come from other states and all across California to come here for their robotic procedures. Oftentimes they've been told at an outside institution that they may need a large open incision, and then we can do it with small incisions with a much quicker discharge. So sometimes it's just the hardest cases that are the robotic cases, but it just kind of depends on the type of surgery.
Why should patients consider robotic surgery?
So the best parts about robotic surgery is that you're going home with either no incisions, a single incision, or very small incisions. And most of the incisions are about the width of my fingernail.
I was just going to ask about how big, so like,
yeah,
this.
8 millimeters. If we're doing a single incision, then it's about 2.5 centimeters.
Mm-hmm.
So all very small.
Okay, and what does multiple incisions mean? Like if you're doing something here and you might have one on this side, one on this side?
Exactly, and sometimes even up to 5 incisions, but they're all very small.
Okay.
So oftentimes you can have multiple small incisions, go home the same day after surgery, have very little blood loss, which is one of the best things, and get back to your life faster. People are off work less amount of time or back to their homework in a shorter period of time.
So those sound like great benefits. You mentioned less blood loss. This means going home more quickly, so like fewer days in the hospital, less risk of infection too?
Absolutely. So decreased blood loss, less risk of infection, less risk of having an open surgery, shorter hospital stay, theoretically going home the same day, less visits to the ICU. So all major benefits.
So when you mention these benefits to a patient who up until now, when they've met you, isn't familiar until robotic surgery, what is their reaction? What are their reactions, questions, concerns?
Sometimes people actually ask me, are you doing the surgery or is the robot doing the surgery?
Right.
Right? And that's one of the most important things to clarify. We're still performing the operation. And if you're familiar with laparoscopic surgery, that's when we make the tiny incisions, but then we put the instruments through those ports and use our hands on them. The major difference is that instead of our hands being on those instruments, the robot is attached to those instruments, and then we sit right next to you, and we're moving the instruments with our hands in a console where we can see better, and we have more control over them. And so we actually have more control over multiple instruments because I can control 4 instruments with my robotic system, where with my actual hands, I can only control 2.
Right, because you've only got 2 hands.
That's right. The other technical parts that are really great is we see in 3D. So when we're doing robotic surgery, we can see in 3D, which is really great because we can get really tiny blood vessels and be very specific. And we also have a 360-degree rotation in our instruments. And it also reduces tremor. So where our hands may have a slight tremor, the instruments have none.
UC Davis was an early adopter of robotic surgery and recently marked 20 years of robotic surgery. Tell us how robotic surgery has, you know, evolved and changed through the 20 years, how we used it then, how we use it now.
Yeah, we were one of the in the forefront of robotic surgery really internationally, and we're lucky to do so, and we've done many thousands of cases to this point. One of the areas we've grown is in so many different specialties and multiple iterations of the robots. So we at UC Davis make sure that we always have the latest models of the robotic systems and that our doctors are very well trained on each new model that comes out. And that's not only in abdomen pelvis surgery, chest cardiac surgery, but also in orthopedics and in neurosurgery. So we kind of always have the next best thing once it's been tested and proven to be safe for patients.
So what do you see in the future for robotic surgery here, both here at UC Davis and more broadly?
So there are multiple areas of growth we still are going to be working on, which is really exciting. So we're adding more and more specialties. So most recently, we started single anesthetic surgery for early lung cancers.
What does that mean, single anesthetic?
So instead of having two procedures where you have a biopsy and then a resection of your cancer, you're doing it all in one with our interventional pulmonologist and our thoracic surgeons.
That sounds great.
It's so much better for the patients. And so what's really special at UC Davis is we have teams, right? We have our staff focused on it. We have our doctors focused on it, our nurses, our equipment specialists. And then we have multiple other areas of growth. We are doing transplant surgery robotic now. We're doing cardiac surgery robotic now. And incisions that used to be very large for like liver and pancreas cancer, we're trying to make those, even though they're big major surgeries that sometimes require large incisions, to go down to the small incisions also.
Wow. I would imagine it, from what you're telling me, patient satisfaction is probably pretty high?
Absolutely. Our patients are ecstatic and super thankful. I mean, if you could have a brain biopsy done robotically through a smaller incision or a spine surgery done through a smaller incision, and also more precise because the robot is a computer that can help us align things more correctly, you're going to have better outcomes and be more satisfied.
We are building a leading edge surgery center at 48th and X. It's going to be called the 48X Surgery Center. Will we see robotic surgery there?
Absolutely. We're very excited about our 48X Surgery Center. It'll be open in the summer of 2025. We're on schedule. And we already have designed four rooms that will be doing robotic surgery in. And it's ideal for patients who are going to have same day discharge or a short overnight stay. So we'll be doing multiple robotic surgeries in 48X.
What are some of the most interesting cases that you've seen with robotic-assisted surgery?
Well, some of my favorite types of cases are just like I talked about the single anesthetic for lung cancer are combined cases. So we can do a colon resection and a hysterectomy at the same time. So two major surgeries for the patient, but all in one, because we have so many robotic surgeons in different specialties that we work together. And so we have robotic pods and robotic teams where we can say, look, this patient needs her gallbladder out, but she also needs this other procedure. Can you take the ovary out and the gallbladder out in one single operation? And those really make the patients really happy, which make us really happy because it helps their lives so much.
In so many ways too. Mm-hmm. So single anesthetic, meaning just a single anesthesia event. Yeah. And they wake up and both procedures have been done.
Absolutely.
What is in the future for robotic surgery broadly? Where do you see this technology heading?
Well, we know there are multiple different robotic systems up and coming, and we're evaluating all of them. We're lucky because we're also building Aggie Square in addition to 48X, and Aggie Square is really going to be a major center for innovation where we will have robotic surgery and training. But I see a lot of more image overlay, so where you can have the MRI, the CAT scan, and combine with your robotic surgery. But in addition to that, our robots are going to be getting smaller. So instead of having these big robotic systems, we can have them in smaller outpatient surgery center and single incision robots. So you have a single handheld robot, and I hope it can be of international use, right? So in more underserved areas, you could actually travel with a single robotic system. You don't need this large footprint, and we can help more people who don't currently have access to robotics.
Amazing. We've learned so much today, learned a lot about robotic surgery. Dr. Nejad, thank you.
Thank you.
This has been our discussion on robotic surgery. Find more interviews and videos on our UC Davis Health YouTube channel and on our website at health.ucdavis.edu. Thanks for joining us.